What makes an effective series pilot? A good pilot introduces the show, characters, and tone that will come when watching the rest of the season, acting as a blueprint for what's to come. It's the first opportunity that the writers and directors have to hook an audience and make them want to continue watching. Shows like Breaking Bad, Community, and Smiling Friends all have very effective pilots. But the one I want to discuss is... Utilizing a successful combination of camera work, editing, music, and direction from LA native Chris Estrada helped This Fool stand out amongst its peers. What I want to discuss today is the focus on Julio and how his interactions inform the audience on the world and the characters within. Since this video is a recommendation, I'm going to break down the effectiveness of Julio's characterization within the first 6 minutes of the show. I feel it best highlights the strength of the pilot, and I hope it inspires you to watch it for yourself. The first real interaction Julio has is outside his house against tough guys blocking his driveway. He attempts to leave but is too nervous to actually confront them, instead driving across his front yard, making an even bigger mess. A very clear physical manifestation of his insecurity affecting the real world. It's then followed by him attempting to convince a gang member to join the rehabilitation program, Hugs Not Thugs. He sounds put together, professional, and confident. Even when the gang member is clearly skeptical about joining, Julio doesn't let that deter him at all. Here we see that there are contrasting sides to Julio. One literally drives across his front lawn rather than engaging confrontation, while the other is a leader for a program helping to turn people's lives around. I also want to draw attention to the song that's playing in the background during his sales pitch, Brendan Wood's You Got Your Fools Mixed Up. A very clever choice, as the lyrics parallel the characterization of Julio in this episode and in the series. The song references a man who wants to distinguish himself from his past behavior. He wants to be seen as an individual, capable of moving on from past relationships by forming new, quote, better ones. It reinforces the duality within Julio that we see in the series. He's not the fool you saw driving across his front lawn. He's not codependent with his ex-girlfriend. He's not the little kid that his cousin keeps treating him as. Or, as Brendan Wood would put it,
I think you got your fools mixed up. You must think I'm somebody else. I'm not the same fool you knew that couldn't help himself.
But the real strength of Julio comes in the way he uses language. He tells a story to prove his street cred, highlighting a violent experience that has continued to stay with him. The gangster, and most likely a good amount of the audience, believe that the story is embarrassing because of Julio's lack of masculinity. He's rollerblading down the street, covered in pads, wearing a goofy outfit, and when the shots start firing, he awkwardly stumbles behind a car. The shooter is revealed to be his cousin, who, in the flashback, fits the typical masculine gangster.
Are you fucking roller skating?
Well, it's actually aggressive rollerblading.
Damn, fool, somehow that sounds even gayer. Hey, say hello to my tío for me, all right? And don't give me any problems or I'll beat your ass.
Okay, I won't.
And then I said, thanks for not shooting me.
At this point, the writer seemed to be presenting what seems to be another joke to showcase Julio's awkward nature. But not only was this choice intentional, but a very clever setup. With all this in mind, let's see how Julio responds to being called out.
Hey, no offense, my boy, but you come off like a punk-ass bitch in that story.
That's my point. My cousin spent the last 8 years in prison. Look, you're gonna do what you're gonna do, but studies show that the life expectancy of a gangster, on average, 24 years old. But the life expectancy of a punk-ass bitch, 76 years old.
This is such a genuinely clever subversion of what I felt was going to be the focus. I remember being so impressed, not just with Julio's observation, but in his presentation and his execution. He's not oblivious to how the story makes him look. He embraces it. He flips the gangster's preconceived notion of needing to fulfill a masculine gangster role, demonstrating how broken that line of thought really is, which ultimately convinces him to join the program. And all of this is within the first 6 minutes of the show. That's effective writing. I didn't go over everything, as I want to encourage you to watch it for yourself. My favorite scene in this episode, and one of my favorites throughout the entire series, is a conversation between Minister Payne and Julio. It's worth it to watch Minister Payne tell Julio the worst thing that he's done. Also make sure to pay attention to Minister Payne's poster, Game, Set, Hope. I missed it on my first watch, but revisiting this episode to make the video, and making sure to both read the quote and the prize he won is indicative of the detail, passion, and effort put into this project.
Thank you.
must think I'm some.